Do you want to add some polish or spice to your scene transitions? Maybe you're thinking of just adding something cooler like this. Today, I'm going to be showing you guys how to set up these scene transitions inside Streamlabs and of course inside OBS, as well as giving you guys a whole pack of free stingers for you to try out and have a play with. Let's go. Hey everyone, my name is Eljay from streamscheme.com. I'm also a variety streamer over at twitch.tv/eljm_. Links to both those in the description. If we don't have a video on this channel covering a topic, then I promise you we have an article over at streamscheme.com covering it. So if you want to find some help, that's a great place to start. All free, get into it. As I said, we've got some really fun stinger transitions for you guys today, as well as some cool polished transitions that we're gonna set up. But before we get into that and show you how to use them, I wanna throw a hey! So this guy actually forgot to tell you guys that we're sponsored. The whole video is sponsored by Own3d. And not just that, but to celebrate the fact that this is our very first sponsor, they've gone an extra mile and given us a bunch of $50 Own3d vouchers for you guys to win. I'll tell you guys how to win those vouchers in a second, but first I'm gonna throw it out there that if you don't know who Own3d are, they are your one-stop shop for all things streaming related. Seriously, you want emotes, they've got emotes. You want full stream packages, you got full stream packages. You guys want anything, including stinger transitions, they've got them. To go in the draw to win the voucher, all you have to do is comment hashtag Own3d, what your Twitch name is so we can get in contact with you. And for bonus points, if you click the link in the description and let us know what you would grab from their site if you had the voucher, there you go, you're in the draw. As I said, there is a link in the description so you can go check those out and see what you want to grab. And a massive thank you to Own3d, our very first sponsor on this channel. If you want to support me, guys, go and support them because obviously it helps the channel. So if you know what stinger transitions are and you just want to get to the installation and download process, check out the time codes in the description and in the top comment. But if you're a beginner, let's just watch through this because I cover everything from basics to setup. So what are stinger transitions? Well, stingers are the name given to these little animations or special transitions to hide cuts. You see, when you click between two scenes, scene A and scene B, it'll just hard cut between them. However, if you add an animation to it, you can hide that cut and make it look much more fluid, much more professional. We're gonna be working with our free stinger pack that we've just released. You can download it in the description by going to our Discord, verifying yourself, and checking out the free resources. We showed off some of these at the start, but there's actually a lot of different ones that we've included in the pack, a lot of variations, so they should fit whatever overlay you're running with. If they don't, let us know. We'll try throw something else in there. And on the topic of free resources, quickly I want to throw it out there. Our free animated overlay packs are fully still available for you. Check them out. They're in the Discord. You can join it, verify and download those at any point. And you can also check out the tutorials on the channel for those overlays to get them all installed and good to go. As well as all the other tutorials on this channel you should check out and maybe consider subscribing and liking, because we've done all this free stuff for you. It's really kind if you did that. So how do we set up and install stingers inside Streamlabs OBS? Well, it's pretty simple. First, what you're gonna do is head over here and make sure you have two scenes already set up and click this little cogwheel. It'll open up your scene transition menu. If you don't see a transition or if you just wanna add a new one, click add transition in the top right. Set it as a stinger when it opens or by clicking this pencil here and changing it. Once you have your stinger selected, you'll get a screen that looks like this. If you don't get this screen, then you can click the cogwheel and select properties as well. To import, just click browse, go to the location of where you have the video files for the stinger you want to use. Make sure you've extracted them, of course. Select the stinger, and it most likely won't be timed right, so you'll have to change that. Click the transition point and then set it to frame. This lets you select the exact frame that will cut from one scene to the other. We want this to line up with the moment the camera is entirely covered. You want to try different numbers if you don't know the exact frame, but often the transition will happen on frame 30 for our stingers. Did it line up? Yes. Awesome. If not, then just add more frames if it transitioned too early or remove frames if it transitioned too late. Once you're done, just click OK and you have your scene transition set up and you can test it by clicking to a different scene. Does it run? Good job. If you want to set up multiple different stingers or add that polished little webcam movement I showed you at the start, that's pretty easy as well. All you have to do is add a new stinger rather than a global, then click connections. Add a new connection, select the scene you want to start on and the scene transition you want to use, and then the scene you want it to end on. Whatever scene transition you set will be the stinger you use. Now, whenever I transition from just chatting to be right back, we have the burn, but anywhere else is the global that I've selected on the transition list. This also has some really cool built-in effects as well that OBS users require a plugin to do. Quick shout out to the OBS users. If you guys need any OBS advice, I actually recommend checking out Nutty. He's a much, much, much smarter person than I am. I think he's one of the best content creators on the entire platform. If you need OBS help, go check him out. The man is a genius. Sorry, back to it. See, if I take my in-game scene and then duplicate it, then move my camera over to the right, then set up a transition between these two scenes using the motion transition type, which you can see on the screen now, and another transition back between them. It means I can have this cool little effect that looks like I'm just moving my camera, but it's actually me transitioning between game one and game two. It looks pretty cool. You should try it out if you're a Streamlabs user. If you're an OBS user, I think Nutty has a whole video on covering that. But speaking of OBS, let's show you guys how to install those OBS dingers now. Honestly, I chose a really good time to do this video because OBS just rolled out a new way to edit and a new way to add stingers. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna need to head down to here. You should be able to see on screen right now, the bottom right of OBS, you'll see a little window that is for your stingers. You'll wanna click on this little dropdown and select stinger, or if you don't see a stinger option, click add stinger. If you're running an older version of OBS, like I said, there was a plus button you'd need to press, but with OBS updated, that is now gone. Once you have a stinger selected, you'll get a screen that looks like this. If you don't get this screen, you can actually click this cogwheel and select properties as well. To import, just click browse, go to the location where you have your video file for the stinger, select it, hit preview, and again, it most likely won't be timed right. So to change it, click the transition point, set it to frame. This lets you select the exact frame that it will cut from one scene to the other. We want this to line up with the moment the camera is entirely covered. You'll want to try different numbers if you don't know the exact frame the cut happens on, but often the transition will happen on frame 30 for our stingers. Set it to 30, hit preview. Did it line up? Yes, awesome. If not, then add more frames if it transitioned too early, or remove frames if it transitioned too late. Once all that's done, click OK and you've got your stinger transition set up. Congratulations, good work. And if you watched this far, thank you. Like the video, I'll see you guys next week.